In the context of the Big Bang era cosmology, astrophysicists became obsessed with explosions, which of course had to be nuclear in nature. Without electrical explanations in their toolbox, most everything had to be explained simplistically in this crude way. However, in regard to the discovery of the hourglass or funnel-shaped form while working at JPL in Pasadena, California, astronomer Raghavendra Sahai exclaimed, "What we thought we understood of planetary nebula, we no longer do. Something different and dramatic is going on." Yes, indeed, astronomer Sahai. In the electric universe cosmology, novas and supernovas are understood as overstressed exploding double layers instead of just aging star nuclear explosions. With plasma phenomena, discharge comes in three levels of intensity: dark mode, glow mode, and arc mode. Thus, dying stars are replaced by stars that are just not in arc mode discharge, but merely in the lesser intensity dark mode, or glow mode. And for the production of such beautiful and intricate structures as the color-enhanced butterfly nebula, the star's throwing off gas explanation is replaced by normal Birkeland current in glow mode, where the currents are necking down on a star in the typical funnel or hourglass shape. By the way, stars never throw off gas. Instead, these highly charged objects discharge very low density fluid plasma, like the solar wind. Our sun generates an outflow of charged particles, and sometimes it burps out solar flares or coronal mass ejections, all consisting of electric plasma. You want to get a disdainful reaction sometime? Just try to explain to a plasma scientist or engineer that low-density plasma can be treated like a gas. The following description of the butterfly nebula appears on the astronomy picture of the day for February 1, 2004. Quote, "Are stars better understood for their art after they die? Actually, stars usually create their most artistic displays as they die. In the case of low-mass stars like our Sun and M29, the stars transform themselves from normal stars to white dwarfs by casting off their outer gaseous envelopes. The expended gas frequently forms an impressive display called a planetary nebula that fades gradually over thousands of years. Much remains unknown about the physical processes that cause planetary nebula." End quote. I emphasize this particular phrase. Quote, "Much remains unknown about the physical processes." Yes, indeed. Again, yes, indeed. The theory that the star is dead or dying and throwing off gas is nonsense from a cosmology that should be dead or dying. The electric universe or plasma cosmology explanation is radically different. The nebular formation seen here, one of the most beautiful and distinctive, seems to be a variation on the ubiquitous hourglass or butterfly-shaped glow-discharge structure, the same general form observed in other nebulas. Sometimes this funnel-shaped formation is seen as a ring or offset oval rings when viewed up the barrel of the axis. This, of course, is the explanation for the otherwise improbable or impossible ring formations, something for which I have yet to see plausibly explained in prevailing cosmology, which talks of barrels or spheres of glowing gas. Simply look at various hourglass nebulas, then look at ring nebulas and visualize that it is the walls of the Birkeland current structure that are glowing, giving a very enhanced effect when viewed parallel to the axis. The star in the center is hardly even visible. It is not in space alone that we observe the unique components of plasma discharge discussed here. The same formations can be seen in the laboratory, though apparently most astronomers may remain unaware that electrified plasma phenomena can generate these observed forms. The hourglass discharge configuration, which may have nested hourglasses as viewed here, is forcing a reconsideration of the physics of nebular formation. Again, according to Sahai, something different and dramatic is going on. Yes, indeed. And not just a little bit different, but radically different. Well, if all this is not compelling, it should be. But astronomer spokesmen have gotten used to throwing an explanation out there, pretty much without regard for a unifying paradigm. If some other astronomer picks up on it and refers to the opinion, it seems to take on a life of its own. Besides, who needs a unifying paradigm or worldview? To some, that even sounds presumptuous. That's God's business, isn't it? However, in this era of the James Webb Telescope, showing us a more ordered and structured universe, maybe the electric universe paradigm can get the attention it deserves. As to the dramatic shape and structure of the Butterfly Nebula, especially the nested hourglasses, this should be a deal killer for explosion type theories, as well as impacting or collision theories, or dying star theories. Let me remind you that Sahai states, it is very hard to see how you get it, but the embedding of similar configurations is not a surprise to those familiar with plasma discharge phenomena. Isn't it time to remember that the very foundation of atoms is electric charge in the form of electrons and protons and neutrons, which decay into these other two? Why do we think that the atom is both the beginning and the end of electric charge influence in the physical universe, which we now know is structured like a three-dimensional web of galaxies connected by glowing, twisting filaments? How can these not be understood as Birkeland currents? The electric universe sees that the atom is not the end of electrical structure. Others are aurora, ball lightning, halos, double layers, and Peratt instabilities. By the way, these latter played a huge role in the major myth-making era. Oh, and throw in waterspouts, tornadoes, and hurricanes. Try to explain globular clusters with their features as something other than electrical structures. Their stars inside just hang there, not revolving around anything. and the clusters themselves form a crown-like ring on the galaxy. Of course, our Sun has nothing but electrical features. Since the proposed nuclear reactions in the core are unobservable and just assumed. The nuclear reactions that do take place on the Sun happen on the surface of the photospheric double layer and are caused not by enormous internal pressure, but by the arc mode plasma discharge. And so it is for other stars. The baffling rotational problems in galactic structure, which spawned the mystical dark matter, are easily explained in the electric universe paradigm. The electrical paradigm explanation goes all the way up to the two galactic superclusters of Virgo and Fornax, which are sometimes considered as opposing lobes of an hourglass shape. If the universe grew by quasar ejection from an original proto-nucleus, it would have a two-lobed structure. And finally, we come back to the latest from the James Webb Telescope. Here is the color-enhanced X-ray image of the neck-down or hourglass-shaped discharge of a star within the dark cloud L1527, which is seen perpendicular to its axis. Look familiar? Look at the Bug Nebula, the Ant Nebula, and especially the Hourglass Nebula. This highly charged star is being fed its energy by Birkeland current necking down on it. Nothing to do with the dying or birthing of the star. The explanations are all far simpler and more mundane than the usual theories are prepared to contemplate. Hannes Alfvén gave us the electrical answer remarkably and very publicly in 1970 in his Nobel Prize acceptance speech. 52 years is long enough to take note. Other electrical engineers and theorists like Ralph Jurgens, Donald Scott, and Wallace Thornhill, all authors of published books and journal articles fostering the electric universe model, have provided a simpler and yet more detailed explanation of the discharge pattern. But there are none so blind as those who have learned not to see. Current cosmological theory has gone off to fantasy land with its phantasmagorical constructs, singularities, dark matter and dark energy, black holes, and the doubly reified space-time continuum. Oh, and false vacuum decay and collapse. Really? False vacuum? Try to imagine that. The whole thing is long overdue for a major overhaul.